Amazing Grace was written by a man who was a slave trader. That's what he did before he became a preacher. By the late 18th century, over 11 million African men, women, and children had been taken from the West Indies to the American colonies. 11 million to be slaves. Great Britain was the greatest superpower at the time, and its empire was built on the backs of these slaves. And amazingly enough, during this time, slavery was accepted by almost all. And John Newton was a well-known slave trader at the time who brought thousands of people to the auction blocks. But in 1748, a violent storm came and almost destroyed his ship. He dropped to his knees, and he asked God for forgiveness. He survived the storm, and he came to the realization that God forgives even the worst of men. Over time, Newton repented, and he became a writer of hymns. And in 1772, he wrote a hymn called Faith's Review and Expectations. Fortunately, his PR group said, let's change the name of this book, Amazing Grace. And it is probably the most popular song in history. So now, fast forward 230 years later, and Chris Tomlin, a contemporary worship leader, was asked to write an additional part to the hymn for a movie about the life of William Wilberforce, who was someone who wanted to abolish slavery. And at first, Chris felt, you don't mess with a song like this, but then God got him thinking about slavery, and the words just came out. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me, and like a flood, his mercy reigns. Unending love, amazing grace. This song, as written there, reached a whole new generation. And it has gone through some additions over the years. Many of you know the most famous verse, when we've been there 10,000 years. John Newton didn't write that. It wasn't in the original. It was added by Mr. Edwin Excel. Don't confuse him with Microsoft Excel. He was this writer who had found out it was in a book in 1852 called Uncle Tom's Cabin. A book that was credited with helped start the Civil War. In the book Uncle Tom's Cabin, which was written by Harriet Beecher Stowe, is a story of a slave named Tom, and he's being beaten to death for his Christian beliefs, and he wouldn't renounce Christianity, and he started singing the verse that we now know for 10,000 years. And then this was added to the song. It's an interesting history on that, isn't it? So there you have it. You got the old, you got the new generation, you have the most popular song in all history becoming even more and more popular. Now the version I have here has some drums in it, so if you don't like drums, now's a good time to go to the bathroom, and I'll be done in 5 minutes, and we'll both feel better when we're done, right?